future are called into a room, set worlds ablaze with our seething fire. Let you all acknowledge that we are here as masters to rule this failing humanity, our beings formed in rage and defiance with strength to trample the weak and the foolish. And so we march with burning plans, temples of flame, and our hearts to glory.
Costumes prepare you for the seasons of marriage to come. In the midst of winter, please remember the silence and calmness of the season and take time to rest. In the spring, please remember the magic of rebirth and regeneration and begin something anew. In the summer, please remember the fiery moments as you embark upon new and exciting adventures together. And in the fall, please remember the spectacular and invigorating aspects of who you are together and who you wish to become. You have a perfect blend of all that is needed in a relationship. You support each other, listen to each other, and respect each other. You both understand that the other is a gift, a precious gift. Yet this gift is not yours alone, but one that is shared with the entire world. In your love for each other, may you find yourselves becoming more than what either of you could be alone. In your support, the other becomes stronger, more complete. In your listening, the other is so fully heard that there is peacefulness. And in your respect, the other is so fully appreciated that they shine so brightly. Your love for each other becomes a gift unto the world and all who come into contact with you. Twilight Keep, you are the result of love of thousands. Today would not be possible without the love of your parents, grandparents, siblings, extended family, and friends. Today we witness the circle of life, all that was extended to both of you, stability, love, support, and nourishment, will now be extended beyond yourselves and into the world. In the spirit of silence, we wish to take a moment now to honor all ancestors and those who cannot be with us here today. There are those who cannot make the trip, and some have left us long ago. There are ancestors that are unknown to us who have been forebearers of the two now before us. Please bring to mind any and all of your loved ones, and with our thoughts, we can add them to our gathering. Parents, you have given your children a mortal gift. The light of this marriage would not be possible without you. Emerson defines success in this way: it is to leave the world a better place by virtue of a redeemed social condition, a patch of garden, or by the way of a child. We congratulate you on your success. You have brought forth life. You have brought forth love. It is most important on your children's wedding day that we thank and bless you. Twyla and Keith, put your relationship on the altar of your lives and dedicate yourselves to it. Remember, as long as you have this, you have everything. Beauty and youth fade away. Money comes and goes. But your love is replaceable. Love is eternal. Since it is your intention to join your marriage, this marriage, do you give it your blessing?
Yes, we do.
I ask that everyone together please repeat after me. We, your family of